Hello friends, magnitude comparator. The comparison of two numbers is an operation that determines whether one number is greater than, less than or equal to other number. A magnitude comparator is a combinational circuit that compares two numbers A and B and determines their relative magnitudes. The outcome of the comparison is specified by three binary variables that indicate whether A equals to B, A greater than B or A less than B. So here we will derive an algorithm for the design of a 4-bit magnitude comparator. So let's start with A equals to B. So two 4-bit numbers will be equal when their each of the bit is equal. So if A3 is equals to B3, A2 is equals to B2, A1 equals to B1 and A0 equals to B0, then we will say that A is equals to B. So how can we do this? So the binary variable, let's say the binary variable is A equals to B. We can define it as like X. So the value of X will be 1 when both of these corresponding bits of the two 4-bit numbers are equal, then only it will be 1. So either both can be 1. So AI, BI, if both are 1, then the result will be 1. Or if both are 0, then we will take their complement. Now also this result will 1. So if both are, so we need, the condition is both these bits should be equal, so either 1 1 or 0 0. So now the value of X will be 1 when both of these bits are equal. I is equals to 0 1 2 and 3. So this is nothing but AI X or BI and this whole complement. So this is basically we have used equivalence operation, or the second name can be exclusive NOR. We can write it as XNOR. Now we will check the condition for A greater than B. So let's call the binary variable as Y. So when will the value of Y be 1? We need to check that. So we are having two 4-bit numbers, A3, A2, A1, A0 is the first 4-bit number and B3, B2, B1, B0 is the second 4-bit number. So we will check from the most significant bit of these two 4-bit numbers. So if A3 is equals to 1 and B3 is equals to 0, so if A3 is equals to 1 and B3 is equals to 0, then clearly we can say that A is greater than B. Then we need not check all the other bits on the right hand side of these A3 and B3. So if A3 is 1 and B3 is 0, then the result will be 1 A3 dot B3 complement. So when we will take B3 complement, it will become 1. So 1 dot 1, we will get 1. So A3 dot B3 complement. So if this is one condition, then we will get the value of Y as 1 that indicates A is greater than B. Now consider A3 and B3 both are same, either 1 or 0. Then we need to check the next bit on the right hand side of the most significant bit. So if A2 is equals to 1 and B2 is equals to 0, then we will say A is greater than B. But when we will move to this condition, when we will check this A2 and B2, when we will compare them, when A3 and B3 are equal. So if A3 and B3 are equal, then we will move to this condition. And we know that when A3 and B3 are equal, the value of X will be 1. So we need to take this value corresponding to I. So I is here 3.
So when A3 and B3 are equals to 1, sorry, when A3 and B3 are equal, X3 will be 1. So the second condition which we will take, X3 A2 B2 complement. Again, how do we get it? When A3 and B3 are equal, A3 equals to B3, then we will check the condition whether A2 is equals to 1 and B2 is equals to 0. If this is there, then we will clearly say that A2 is greater than B2. So from these two values, we need the result 1. So that Y will be 1, indicating that A is greater than B. So we will get it like A2 value is 1, B2 value is 0. So we will take its complement, B2 complement. Now both of these bits are 1, so we will get their AND operation as result will be 1. And since we moved to this condition, after this condition is true, so here we get the result X3, which indicates that A3 is equals to B3. So we need to take AND operation with X3 also. So X3 and A2 and B2 complement. So either this condition is true or this condition is true. If both A2 and B2 are equal, then we will move to this condition, and here we need to take the AND of X3 and X2, means A3 is equals to B3, A2 is equals to B2. Now we will check A1 equals to B1. So here X3, X2, A1, B1 complement. If both of these bits are also equal, then we will check this condition, whether A naught is equals to 1 and B naught equals to 0. So here X3, X2, X1, this indicates A3 equals to B3, A2 equals to B2, A1 equals to B1. So all the three value will be 1. And now we will take their AND with A0, B0 complement. So this will be the expression for A greater than B. Now in the exact fashion, we can derive the Boolean expression for the A less than B. So let's call this binary variable Z. So the value of Z will be 1 when B3 equals to 1 and A3 equals to 0, or if both of these are same, then we will check whether B2 equals to 1 and A2 equals to 0. If these are also equal, then we will move on B1 and A1. B1 equals to 1, A1 equals to 0, then we will say B is greater than A. If both of these two bits are also equal, then we will move to the next bit on the right hand side. Then we will check whether B naught equals to 1 and A naught equals to 0. So all the four terms will be same, only this complement will change because we are checking the condition B is greater than A. So this complement will shift from B to A. So it will become B3 A3 complement plus X3 B2 A2 complement plus X3 X2 B1 A1 complement plus X3 X2 X1 B0 A0 complement. So this will be the Boolean expression for the binary variable Z, which indicates B is greater than A. Now we can implement this in the circuit diagram using the logic gates.